Line me up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Stir. Take back now. Slowly. 1, 2, 3, in.
Thank you.
Then I can do the council order after that, okay? Set? One, two, three. About Sunday, I would like to be there at 1:30. Bring your own music stand, okay? And I'd like a red, white, and black colored combination, okay? And make sure you're wearing a mask when you go in. We will probably leave our instrument cases in the room that the citizen band used to practice in. And we'll be playing, if all things go well, my meeting on Friday, we'll be playing in the church proper. So, we'll be able to do that. I think that'd be nice. I would think going to the fellowship hall would be the easiest way to do it. The way we went in through the worship. Right, Tony? Yeah, not going in through the chapter of the church. But in entering through the fellowship hall with your folks, and you know, move your hat to the really comfortable. And the public is invited, and it's free. I don't know, there may be a donation bucket off the church. So, any questions? But I wouldn't take up the parking lot with the band on this, the audience coming out. Okay?
Is it a 2:30 concert?
The concert's at 2:30. Oh, this is interesting.
That's why I haven't spoken to you. It's like playing on fire.
Let's try to get a nice audience. After Sunday, I haven't set the date for the first rehearsal yet. It's usually on Martin Luther King Day. I don't know when they're going to start the semester, but it's usually then. Maybe a week earlier, a week later. And not that you people aren't wonderful, but I knew people we had before that were a little bit of trepidation for the first semester if they want to join us. They're welcome. Okay.
copies for your refrigerators. And then pick one up on the way out if you want to. We're very happy to have the Utica concert band today, directed by Michael Camille. So please enjoy. Thank you.
We're going to open our concert today with Sousa March, called Bullets and Bayonets. Concert was not a foregone conclusion, so we're really happy to be here. really happy to be here to, who's playing in front of you this afternoon, I should say, are about 30 musicians from the 60 musicians we had right before COVID. The last rehearsal we had 60 people. And we came here in August, at the end of August, and we really had some culture shock as to what we heard. And I want to tell you, these people have really, really, really worked hard to make an ensemble out of 30 different musicians. And, you know, with the different people playing different instruments, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And I'm so very proud of these people, what they've accomplished. We had a great Veterans Concert, and we hope to give you a nice concert today. A little bit of our traditional, some of the stuff in the Veterans Concert, and some of the songs from the season, as you can see in the program. The next selection is one of the favorites of mine. I tend to have the bands perform it pretty regularly, but I love to conduct it, and I love the way that people do it. And it's called Ballet Parisien, and it's from, it's written, it's a French composer, Jacques Offenbach, and it's a movement, I'm sorry, it's a piece in five movements, all dances, and you got to picture yourself in a dance hall in, you know, one of those big show pieces in Paris. And the first one is the overture, the second one is a waltz, the third one I think is a gallop, the fourth one is another waltz, and the fifth one is the finale. So please hold your applause till we do all five movements, and we hope you really enjoy it. This is Ballet Parisien by Jacques Offenbach. I'll go with the French, okay? Okay, well, thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. work out. That was a lot of fun. Actually, this is a, we used to go to the nursing homes this time of the year, which we can't, unfortunately. Those were wonderful concerts. See the people who really don't, can do much anymore, mouth the words of carols and stuff, and tapping their feet, and having aides come up to us afterwards and said, this is the most emotion we've seen from these people, and they were so heartwarming, and we can't do that. But we're going to replace that concert this Sunday with, we had a wonderful invitation from the New Hartford Presbyterian Church on Genesee Street in Hartford, and allow us to perform a concert there at 2:30 on Sunday afternoon. It's free, open to the public. Mm-hmm. I'm pretty sure masks will be required, but nonetheless, and we will play fewer of the veterans' concert songs and more of the holiday songs at that bad time. We'll try to keep the concert to about an hour and 15 minutes, so it's not too long. People aren't in contact too long. There will be no intermission. And we hope you come. We hope you come. It should be a great day. It should be a great day. We're looking forward to it. And this is the first time. Well, outside of the fact that one year, I'm sorry, MVCC did invite us to do a joint Christmas concert with the Capitol Theater, which is wonderful. Speaking of the Capitol Theater, next Tuesday night, the Capitol Theater is hosting Tuba Christmas. And I have the honor of being the conductor this year. And it's very special to me because the concert is being dedicated to one of my music education colleagues who passed away over the last year, Loyal Mitchell. Actually, Loyal started Tuba Christmas in the area, you know, great bluegrass player. And so we're going to do this concert in his honor and memory next Tuesday night at the Capitol Theater. I'm pretty sure, I don't know if there's any admission. Is there ever admission? No, it's probably free and open to the public. I understand the renovations of Capitol Theater came out wonderful, and it's a great place to be, great place to watch a concert. I'm sure it's a great place to perform, so I'm looking forward to that also. So two big things coming up within the next 7 days, and we hope that you can take part in that. I know it's a busy time of the year for everybody. What are we going to do now? Oh, okay. The next lecture we're going to play for you is called Deep Purple. Now, this was written by Pete DeRose, and the neat part about this song is that you've heard it sung, you've heard it played with orchestras, you've heard it played with jazz groups or pop groups or the 40s jazz groups, but this song was written originally for just a piano, solo piano. And what we try to do with our interpretation is make believe we're the solo piano player and do the rubatos and all the emotion that they put into it. And that's kind of neat. They've worked with me quite hard on this piece. We hope that that comes across to you. Deep Purple by Pete DeRose.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Well, we have a little break here. I don't want to go unnoticed. You know, this is a time of year for traditions. We keep traditions. Unfortunately, a tradition comes to an end today. Dr. David Moore has been in charge of the lunch hour series ever since I've been here at Utica College, is retiring from this position at the end of today. Oh, okay. Next semester?
No, I get to see you one more time.
You get one more concert? Forget it. No, honestly. However, he takes care of all the arrangements. He gets us fed, he gets us chairs, and if we can get the side door unlocked for a half hour before the rehearsal, that would be even better. But nonetheless, I'd like a hand for Dr. Moore. There's a couple of important ladies in our department here. First of all, our department chairman, Laura Salvaggio, who works so very hard to get the band to meet. I'm not close to you without a mask, I'm sorry. Got the band permission to meet and perform and go through all the protocols and everything that we needed to do it. Whenever pressed against obstacles, we worked together again. She went to bat for us, and so I'd like to recognize Dr. Salvaggio. And Professor Wise is our dean of arts and sciences. And when Laura couldn't get high enough to the top, the dean won for us, and that's I wish they could be here today, but I know they have very busy schedules. But I want to thank them, and if you see them, if you have to work here, don't tell me you have longer hair now. Or what? Oh my Lord! I'm so used to this little bob. Thank you so much for all you've done, Sharon. They have certainly jumped through hoops for us, and we appreciate it. We appreciate it very, very much. So I wanted to recognize those people before everyone started leaving. I know we're going a little long, but if you want to bear with us, we have some Christmas tunes that I think you'd enjoy. This first one's kind of lighthearted. It's called Together at Christmas. It's got Winter Wonderland, Let It Snow. On the 24th, of course, only. Have yourself a Merry Little Christmas, and it's a marshmallow. Ready? One. One, two. One, two, three, and.
Thank you.
just a finale. I don't want to keep it too long if you want to hear more Christmas. You got to come Sunday. Number 91. Christmas report, 91. Yeah, he's next, right? Ready? Watch. One. One cut. One, two. One, two, three, and.
Thank you.
Thanks, everybody. Happy, safe, healthy.
Thank you.